हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड स्टेइंग होम सेफली. सो टुडे वी विल स्टडी अ न्यू चैप्टर. फर्स्ट आई विल इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ. अर्चना तिवारी, सब्जेक्ट टीचर ऑफ कंप्यूटर एंड जीके फ्रॉम एलपीएम पब्लिक स्कूल सिचुएटेड इन गोला बाजार गोरखपुर. ओके, सी टुडे वी विल लर्न स्टडी अ न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर वन. इन प्रीवियस वीडियो आई सेंड पार्ट वन रिविजन एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ चैप्टर फर्स्ट इंट्रोडक्शन टू IPO. इन IPO आई टेल यू वॉट इज अ कंप्यूटर. कंप्यूटर इज अ स्मार्ट मशीन. इट फॉलोज द कमांड्स गिवन बाय द यूजर. इट हैज फोर मेन पार्ट, दैट इज मॉनिटर, CPU, कीबोर्ड एंड mouse, and each part of computer performs different functions. And computer works in three step, that is input, processing, output. That's why it is known as the IPO cycle. Okay, in that we have input. Input means, I explained you in previous video that input means what? Whatever the data or instruction given by the user to a computer is known as input. Every data instruction given is input, and what are the every actions are taken on input is a process. Every action is a process, and the result of every action is output, and the result of every action is output. Okay, see, today I'm going to explain you about the advantages of a computer. Advantages of a computer. In advantages of a computer, we have at least 6 points of is given there as the advantages of a computer. First one is speed. A computer can perform any calculation at a very high speed. Whatever the calculations or whatever the works are done in a computer, it should be perform or calculate at a very high speed. It can be performed or calculate at very high speed. It means computer works very fast. Second one is accuracy. A computer never make mistakes. It always gives correct results. Mistakes are generally done by the user. It means whatever the works done by the user in a computer, it always be correct. A computer never make mistake. Means computer doesn't make mistakes. It always gives the correct results. Mistakes are generally done by the user. If there is some mistakes in a computer doing the work, it means the mistakes are generally done by the user. Why? Because computer never makes mistakes. A user who is using the computer can make mistakes. By the mistake of the user only, a computer gives the incorrect results. Otherwise, computer never make mistakes and it never gives the incorrect results. Okay, always computer always accurate in his work. He always be give the correct results. Mistakes are always done by the user only. Third is, that is versatility. In versatility, computer can efficiently perform a variety of tasks. It means, for example, it can play music, calculate, share information and much more. It means what? At a time, computer can do a variety of tasks. Computer can able to have a capability to do the many multimedia works. Okay, he performs many variety of tasks efficiently. It can play music, it can calculate, it can share information and etc. Like that, a computer can work many variety of tasks. Okay, then to come to the fourth one, that is storage capacity. That is what? Storage capacity. See here, storage capacity A computer has a huge storage capacity. A computer has a huge storage capacity. It can store a large amount of data. This data can be used any time you want. What see? A computer has a very huge storage capacity. Whatever the data and instructions stored in a computer, we can whenever we want we can use that data anytime. Why? Because a computer has a huge storage capacity and it can store a large amount of data. Means whenever the user is using a computer, he is doing performing his particular task, completing his particular task in a computer by giving the data and instructions. All the data and instructions are stored in a computer. It is stored in storage because a computer has a very big storage capacity, and in that it computer can store large amount of data. A computer can easily store all the large amount of data in a storage capacity. That data or information whatever stored in a computer, we can be used any time whenever we want. Whenever we want, we can use any time because each and every one should be stored, already stored in a storage capacity. Now come to the next class, that is diligency. That is diligency. See here, in diligency, a computer does not get tired. A computer does not get tired. It can work for long hours without needing any break. As a human being, whenever we are working, we always get tired. But a computer is a machine. Okay, it is a machine. So a computer does not get tired. It can work for long hours without needing any break. It means without taking a break, a computer can work for long hours. A computer can work for a long, long hour without a break because a computer does not get tired. Why it does not get tired? Because it is a machine. Because computer is a machine. Okay, now last one, that is multitasking. That is what? Multitasking. See here. Multitasking. A computer can perform multiple tasks at the same time. A computer can perform multiple tasks at the same time. For example, it can play music while you are typing. In multitasking, what happens? If we are doing some work on a computer, we are typing anything, if the user is typing anything on a computer, at additional he want to listen a music, he can be listen a music also, and he can also type it on the computer. It means a computer can perform multitask at the same time. It means clear that a computer can at a time a computer can work more than one work, one job. A computer can perform more than one work at a same time. So that's why a computer is also known as the multitasking. A computer is also known as the multitasking. Okay. Next is, that is, after that completion of the advantages of a computer, now come to the next one, that is limitations of a computer. In limitations of a computer, see here there are 3 points, that is, first one is no feeling, dependent on humans, zero IQ. In no feeling, see here, a computer does not have any feeling, it is a non-living thing. As like a human being, a computer does not have any feelings. Why? Because a computer is a machine and machine is a non-living thing. Machine is a non-living thing, and a non-living thing does not have any feelings. Okay, a machine does not have any feelings. Second one, come to that, is dependent on humans. Dependent on humans. A computer is a man-made machine. It cannot do anything on its own. A computer is a I previously told you that computer is a machine. It is not made by nature. It is a man-made machine and cannot do anything on its own. Without any help, we can do our work easily. But a computer is a machine and it is a man-made machine. So computer cannot do anything on its own. Whatever the data and instructions a user give on that purpose, inserted by the user a data and instruction, the computer takes action and do the job. But if we say computer do the work, a computer cannot be able to do the work by its own. Next come to that is zero IQ. See here, zero IQ. In zero IQ, IQ stands for intelligence quotient. IQ stands for intelligence quotient. A computer has no intelligence of its own. Even like a computer is a man-made machine, it doesn't have its own intelligence. It doesn't have its own intelligence. Like human beings, a human beings have its own intelligence, but a computer does not have its own IQ. For example, if you enter incorrect information on the computer, it cannot correct it and it will show you the incorrect result. I told you, whatever the information given by the user to the computer always take action on that particular instructions. Computer take action on that particular instructions. If we enter incorrect information on the computer, then computer can so the incorrect result. Why? Because we had feed the incorrect result. But why? Because computer doesn't have his own IQ. Whatever the instructions we are giving, computer always work on that particular data and instructions given by the user. So computer never makes mistakes, but the user have made the mistakes. But the user make mistakes, okay? So if we are giving the incorrect information, then computer will show the incorrect result, okay? So in computer terminology, this is called garbage in, garbage out. So for this process, in computer terminology, it is called garbage in, garbage out. It is a short form is GIGO, G-I-G-O, G-I-G-O, and G-I-G-O stands for garbage in, garbage out. Okay, by this we have completed our chapter 1st revisional explanation. So once again we will go as a flashback of whole chapter. See here, a computer has four main parts. Four main parts, that is monitor, CPU, keyboard and mouse. Okay. Second point, a computer goes through three steps to perform any task, that is input, processing, output, or we say IPO cycle. Input is the data and instructions given to the computer. Whatever the data and instruction given to a computer is known as input. Fourth point, processing is the action of converting the input into a meaningful result. Processing is the action of converting the input into a meaningful result. In computer, we have only one processing device, that is known as CPU, which is also known as the brain of a computer. CPU is also known as the brain of a computer, and CPU stands for Central Processing Unit. Now come fifth point, output. Output is the result displayed by the computer after processing. It means whatever the input given by the user, the action taken and processed, and after processing whatever the action is taken is known as the result of output. It is known as the output, okay? So after processing of a computer, the computer displays the result. That result is known as the output. Then 6 point, a computer is fast, accurate and multitasker. A computer is fast, accurate and multitasker. It means a computer works very fast, is always, a computer always accurate in its work, and it is a multitasker. It means at one time it can do many work at a same time. A computer has no feeling and intelligence. A computer has no feeling and intelligence means a computer is a not a human being. It is a man-made machine and it is a non-living thing. That's why a computer has no feeling and no IQ. A computer has no feeling and no IQ. So this is the flow of CR, flow chart of IPO cycle, input, processing, output. So by this, we have completed our chapter 1st divisional explanation. So thanks to listen me, all of you. Have you completed chapter 1st in your fair copy or whatever the book exercise and question answer I sent you in the PDF? Have you completed in your fair copy? If you not, so please complete it in your fair copy, and the works and the handwriting should be good, neat and clean. Keep maintain the book notebooks hygiene also, and be concentrated with your studies. Be concentrated with your study. Don't go out of safe yourself with corona. Bye. See you. We will meet in the next video.